Okay, so let's walk through our melody composition in melodic minor. This is a lot like what we did in major a few weeks ago. So the first thing is to get your time signature in there and your key signature. Now I'm using one that's in G melodic minor, but you might have one that's in D or F or some other key. So just like we did with our major melody assignment, you can only skip between notes that are scale degrees 1, 3, or 5. So 1, 3, and 5 in my G key is G, B, and D. So I'm only allowed to jump between notes if they're the letters G, B, or D. Everything else must move by step. So, okay, I'll keep that in mind. And then usually, just like in any song, we want to hover around scale degrees 1 and 5. In G, that's G and D. In the key of D, that's D and A. In the key of C minor, it would be C and G. So it's always the starting note from the scale and then the fifth letter up. Now, our template file already has our exercise set up so that there are five measures, so that's all set for us. And in the last measure, our only whole note that we are allowed is the very last measure, the fifth measure, will have a whole note that is the name of our scale. So in my case, that's going to be a G. And in your case, it might be a D or an F or whatever note is the main note of your scale. So if it's G, like this instance, it needs to be the note G at the end. If it's D at the end, then it needs to be the note D at the end as a whole note. Finally, the hard part we'll take care of once we have a little bit of melody written. So I'm going to just stick with quarter notes like I usually do, keeping things simple. And I'm going to start on G because that is the rule. And I think I will start up high like that this time. And I'm just going to walk down. So I'm just walking down through the letters. I'm on a B. I think I want to jump to a new note. So how about up to D? So B to D is okay, because that's my third to my fifth note of the scale. Now I'm walking up. I'm just going to walk up to G again. Maybe do some more skipping. I'm allowed to jump down to D or B. And then I'm going to do some stepping. I know I need to get low at some point or another, right? And there's my G at the end. So mostly stepwise motion. And if I skip, it must be between the first, third, or fifth scale degrees of the scale that I've been assigned. In this case, G, which means G is 1, B is 3, really B flat, and then 5 is D. All right, so now I've got a melody that works with all the rules, but I still haven't checked my melodic part, right? Which is that if it's going up, if they're heading upward, if it's scale degree 6 or 7, it needs to be raised by a half step. And then if it's going down, it needs to be lowered back to natural minor. Now I know that since I don't have any sharps or flats in here, this is natural minor right now. But I need to make sure that it's melodic. So I'm going to look for every spot that is a 6 and a 7. And then see which direction they're going. So in this case, this is 1, G, which means back one step in the scale, that's a 7. Now the question is, which way is the 7 going? Is the 7 going downwards? Or is the 7 going upwards? And in this case, it's going downwards, so it should be natural minor, so I'm actually safe. This is a 6 then. That's also going downwards, so it's also safe to be natural minor. These I don't have to worry about. And now I'm going up. Here, I run into a 6, right? That is E flat 6. So, it's heading up. That means I must raise this note by a half step. So I need this to be E natural, since the key signature has made it E flat. So I'm going to raise my E. And it goes up to F, that's the seventh. So that one also needs to be raised by a half step from normal F, natural F, to F sharp. And then I can go down, going down. Here's another seventh. So that's a G, this is one letter down, that's F. It's not going anywhere for a minute, but it eventually, it repeats, right, two Fs, but it goes up eventually. So, that means that since my Fs eventually rise, I need to raise them. And now I have F sharp going to G. So I'm going to play this back and see what I think. And it works pretty well. And then I might mess with the rhythms a little bit, like always. Maybe do a little dot here, here and there. Maybe this one too. And I'm gonna add just a little flourish here just for fun. Maybe I'll go. Well, I can't skip here. I've caused myself a problem because I go G, A, B, A, right? So that means A is not allowed to jump down to D in this case. So I'm just gonna change the rhythm so that my B here can jump down. Let's see how that sounds. So I'm going to turn it into an eighth so that that fits. So now I go F sharp. And I think I want a little bit of movement here too. So I'm going to speed things up. I'm going to have my F sharp go G. Like that. And let's see what we get now. Yeah, it's almost something I like. I'm gonna actually just make that another eighth note. It was too busy there. And maybe we'll go, that should work. Let's see. Yeah, I have a totally fine minor melody. I might play with it more if I'm in the mood, but this would perfectly work fine. I just need to double check that all my sixes and sevenths that rise, and it's really about where they're going next. So six goes up next, so it needs to be raised. F is seven, it goes up next, so it needs to be raised. And then I can jump around when I'm allowed. And, you know, I really just didn't like this part, so I'm gonna do that. And maybe hear it one more time. Yeah, and I like my melody much better now. And then I'm finally going to go to File and do my Export to PDF and then turn it in Canvas. And then we're all set. And writing more and more music as the course goes on. So hopefully that's fun. Okay, good luck.